Thank you. Of Hall and Conard seniors. She's kind of begin to assemble on the inside of the protective net adjacent to the team's benches. Thank you.
Yeah. Ready? Around. Don, the other side of the bar. You gotta go to the bleachers.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Robert J. McKee Stadium. It is now my privilege to introduce those seniors who will participate tonight in their final Paul Conard Crosstown Lacrosse Contest. First, the senior class of Warriors. Number 5 in Associa, Josh Goodman. Number 27 in Associa, Colin Ward. Number 7, Steve Wahlberg.
Can you finish?
Yeah.
Number six, Jack Canega. Jack is joined with his parents, Matt and Amanda. Steve Wahlberg with his parents, Stephen and Kimberly. Number 13, Lucas Danny. Accompanied by his mother, Christine, and his sister, Rylan. Number 21, Gia Garcia. She is joined by his mom, Espinosa. Number four, Ben Fisher. Ben is joined by his parents, Ron and Kathy. Number 37, Jake Brisson. Jake is escorted with his mom, Julie. Number 10, Tyler Strickling. Todd is accompanied by his parents, Daryl and Sandy. Number 12, AJ Esperanza. AJ is with his parents, John and Natalie. Thomas Covet, number two, with his dad, Kurt. Number 25, Harrison Newman. Harrison escorted by his parents, Brian and Lori. Number one, Captain Jordan Weinstock. Jordan is escorted by his mom, Melissa, and his dad, Randy. And number 28, Captain Kevin Carr. Kevin is joined by his dad, Steve, and his mom, Linda. Congratulations, gentlemen. ladies and gentlemen, now introducing your Houston class of 2016. Number one, Captain Zach O'Connor. Zach is joined by his parents, Delia and Mike, and his brother, Grant. Number three, Jack Durando. Jack is escorted by his mom, Beth, and his dad, Steve. Grayson is joined by his mom, Catherine, and his dad, Don. Number six, Captain Andrew Hollebach. Andrew's accompanied by his mother, Tracy, and his dad, John. As well as his brother Ben. Number seven, Pete Croon. Pete's joined by his mom and dad, Chris and Mike. Bobby's escorted by his mom, Piper Faulkner. Number nine, Tyler Carson. Brother Tyler is his dad, Jim, and his brother, Will. Number 11, Captain Tyler Granger. Tyler's joined by his mom, Melissa, and his stepdad, Keith Sanzini. Luke Fleggy, wearing number 12. Luke is escorted by his parents, Mary Ellen and Steve. Number 13, Captain Matt McCormick. Matt's accompanied by his mom, Juliana, and his dad, Chris. Number 17, John Lee. John is escorted by his mom, Miguela. Number 18, number 19, Justin Ferrier. Justin is joined by his mom and dad, Jane and Papa Tom, and his brother, Jared. Number 20, Shannon Boyd. Shannon's with his parents, Kristen Norton, and his dad, Brian. Number 24, Bryce Williams. Joining Bryce are his parents, Pamela and Robert. Number 25, Jordan Dorfman. Joined accompanied by his parents, Tammy and Marshall. Number 26, Nate Richmond. Joining Nate is his mom, Michelle. Number 34, Ian Geary. Ian is there escorted by his mom, Deb, and his dad, John.
Omar.
Number 43, Patrick Corcoran. Chad is joined by his mom, Suzanne, his dad, Kevin, and his brother, Andrew. And number 44, Phil Simplicio. Phil is accompanied by his parents, Julie and Chip, and his brothers, Tim and Peter.
Omar, I see you.
Congratulations, gentlemen. Thank you for your dedication to Conard Lacrosse. You truly personify Season 5. Ladies and gentlemen, we ask now that you please rise as we honor America with the singing of our national anthem, performed by Conard's a cappella ensemble, UJQ.
Oh,
school administration, our athletic department, we welcome your attendance this evening. Couple of heads up, your head coach for the visiting Warriors, Mr. Ben von Meyerhausen.
And welcome back, everybody, to McKee Stadium at Conard High School. It's the nightcap of our lacrosse doubleheader. As now the boys take center stage as the Conard Chieftains and Hall Warriors battle for their only time this season. Pete Lamoureux joined by Adam Ryder and our Channel 5 crew. It's been an interesting year for Bill Condon's veteran squad. They started 0-4, have now won 9 of 11 to get to 9-6 on the season, and they're led by a pair of seniors who are known for their work during the winter. Hockey captain Matt McCormick and basketball's Jack O'Connor have combined for 47 goals, while Henry Neidel leads all scorers with 30 on the season. Meanwhile, for Ben von Meyerhauser and the Hall Warriors, they were 500 to start the year at 4-4, but they've dropped 7 in a row as they look to end the 2016 campaign on a high note. A couple of hockey players, Kevin Carr and Kyler Cubbage, are prominent on this team, as is A.J. Speranza, and congratulations to him. A.J. has been named a CIAC Scholar Athlete. Nice to work the second game with Adam. And Adam, how does this Hall team look to slow down a juggernaut like the Conard Chieftains?
If I'm Coach von Meyerhauser, I'm telling my guys to value every single possession. Don't get emotional because this is Hall Conard. This is the game everyone looks for forward to all year long. Don't look to outscore them early. This is a team, a Hall team, it's only scored 88 goals on the season. And as you mentioned, O'Connor and Neidel, along with Andrew Hollebach, have combined for nearly as many goals as the entire Hall team has all season. So when you value your possessions, if you have to rush a shot every now and then just to keep up with them, then you have to do that. But it's valuing possessions and trying to keep the score low, because the pressure is going to be on Conard, who still has hopes for a Class L state playoff berth. The pressure is on them. For Hall, it's relaxing and just trying to go out and win one final game for your 14 seniors.
And that Conard team, as you talked about in terms of playoff positioning, currently ranked 13th in Class L right now. Conard 10-6 a season ago, lost to Brian McMahon in the first round of that Class L tournament. What a job Bill Condon has done here with the Chieftains. 25th year at the helm, has 312 wins. Number 300 came a year ago when they defeated East Lyme, and he's had a heck of a lacrosse pedigree. Started the program at Holy Cross of Waterbury, and his best years at Conard, 2000 and 2008, both of those campaigns, he went at 16-4. On the other side of the ledger, for Ben von Meyerhauser, his first year, inherits a team that graduated 5 seniors. Talk about his background. He played on the 1998 CCC West Championship team at Hall, then went on to prep a year at Avon Old Farms before going on to Trinity. Ben is assistant coach for football and basketball, and having an opportunity to talk with him and the other head coaches a week ago, he has a very interesting philosophy recruiting youngsters that have the great, not only athletic skill, but that football slash lacrosse mentality. And he wants to have them instilled at a young age as he turns this team around. He's getting freshmen and sophomores, and it'll be interesting to see where this team progresses in the next 2 years.
Absolutely. You need physical play in lacrosse, especially against a team like Conard, with 5 double-digit goal scorers, 2 30-goal scorers, 3 20-goal scorers. And you mentioned installing the physicality in young players, and the one to look out for on Hall tonight is going to be Jack McHale, who, just a freshman, already with 14 goals on the season, which is actually tied for the team lead along with Spencer Witter, who's just a sophomore himself. So a very young Hall team here, possibly a sign of things to come. If they can keep this close, look out for this Hall team next year.
One thing that Coach von Meyerhauser happy about is the fact that 3 of their 4 wins have come in fourth quarter comebacks, and that's not something that you see very often in lacrosse. Their wins this year for the Warriors against Northwest Catholic. They also defeated Suffield, Avon, and Newington. Unfortunately for them, they have not won a game since way back on April the 27th. Over the years, it's been a rivalry that's been dominated by Conard. They defeated Hall 15-7 a year ago. They've now won four consecutive matches. Last time that Hall came out victorious in this matchup was back in 2011 when the Warriors posted a 14-13 win. They also won in 2010 by the count of 16-14. Getting set for the faceoff, as it will be Patrick Corcoran to take it for the Conard Chieftains. And we're just about set to be underway with a nightcap of our doubleheader here on WHC-TV Channel 5. Battles for it there along with Jordan Weinstock, and is controlled by Hall, and the first possession goes to Andrew Crivetti. Crivetti speeds into the zone and shoots, and it goes just high and wide. He tried to pick the upper corner with the first shot of the game.
And already a quick start for Hall, just missed, but again, good backup as they maintain possession here, looking to draw first blood here early in the first.
Chris Mons had the ball and hands off to Kevin Carr, hockey captain as well as lacrosse great, as Hall maintains possession, setting up for what they hope is the game-opening goal. This is Griffin Smith, just a sophomore, first year at the varsity level. Good face-off kid, quiet, very unassuming kid on this Von Meyerhauser first squad. He's met near midcourt right there by Jordan Dorfman. You recognize that name from the football team. He and Nate Richam both get time. Both were running backs for Matt Sersosimo's Conard Chieftain football team that went 8-3 a year ago. Now here's Chris Mons with the ball. He's being watched by Tyler Granger. We mentioned Granger's name, the senior defender who was an all-league performer a year ago, and he's their number one matchup guy. He's going to play at Western New England College in Springfield. There's a shot, and the save is made. Tyler Carson's been strong in net for the Conard Chieftains, and he made a big stop right there. Nate Richam throws the ball back, and it's retrieved by Carson. Hands it off to Tyler Granger. Long pass downfield as he's looking for Henry Neidel. He's got it. Oh, the save is made. What an opportunity. Great pass, great shot. And up to the task, Harrison Newman, first big save for Hall.
And the senior showing he's no slouch. One-on-one breakaway, and Newman coming up big, keeping the Chieftains off the board early, though Hall is unable to keep the loose ball as Conard will maintain possession here.
They're on the attack for the first time in the game. This is Jack O'Connor back behind the net. You recognize that name from the basketball team where he scored 16 points per game last year and was very instrumental in their victory at home over Hall, the game that we broadcast right here on Channel 5. Matt McCormick, we interviewed him after the hockey win. Nice pass in front, but not having an angle that time was Hollerback. And they score. The first goal of the game goes to the Chieftains with 9:21 to go in the opening quarterback. Andrew Hollerback gets the goal. And it's 1-0.
And some quick passing inside there, turning Newman every which way but loose. He tried to keep up, but just one too many. Excellent, quick, short passes inside, and just no shot for Newman on that one.
So he made the first big stop on the breakaway, but it was Hollerback getting the better of him that time, and the Chieftains have a 1-0 lead. And here they come looking for more. Down the field is Robert Iverson, a senior, one of the seniors honored before the contest here tonight. Conard maintains possession with Henry Neidel, 30-plus goals on the season. He's been a big offensive performer for head coach Bill Condon and company. Spinning away from the defense and then gets it back outside. And this is Matt McCormick. Passes it to Peter Carone. Actually, this is Jack O'Connor with the ball. Back outside. They swing it left side. And the spin move doesn't work. So they go back of the net. And fanning on the shot was Henry Neidel. He was set up well that time. Ball is loose, recontrolled by Hall. Long shot, and the save is made. Nice stop right there by Newman on the long-range shot from just inside the 30-yard line.
Hollerback looking for two quick ones there. He got off a laser, but Newman more than equal to the task.
And off the turnover, Jack O'Connor finding the back of the net. Quick transition for the Chieftains that time. And at 8:10 to go in the opening quarter, 2-0 for the Chieftains. This is a problem that has plagued Hall. The turnovers, not playing as well in the neutral zone. It's kind of, as we look at this game here tonight, Adam, it's almost a mirror image of what we saw in the opening game with a big advantage to a more veteran team for the Conard Chieftains. And the same holds true in the boys' game as well.
And you mentioned the turnovers for Hall, not just turnovers, turnovers deep in your own defensive territory where there's so little time to react. And Newman, again, no chances, O'Connor not missing his one-on-one opportunity there. It's open.
They win another faceoff, and the Chieftains will try for more. Jack O'Connor, all-league performer a year ago. Had two goals in the recent setback that they had to Glastonbury.
Nice move, Matt.
And a shot by McCormick goes high and wide. So we talked about Matt McCormick, captain of the hockey team. At 12 goals, 26 assists, 38 points in hockey. 17 goals, 17 assists, 34 points in lacrosse. Talk about a consistent performer. Well, there's in sneakers or on skates. Nice pass and the resulting shot goes wide. Chieftains maintaining possession as they try to add to a 2-0 advantage. There's another bounce shot and that one goes home. Henry Neidel, the junior midfielder who has 30 plus goals on the season. Basketball player during the winter. Big finisher on offense. As we talked about with Steve Boyle in the first game with the girls, that is such a weapon when you can able to use that bounce shot to your advantage.
Absolutely. And going from high to low, Newman unable to judge exactly where that ball was going to bounce, going low, and Newman made a nice few nice stops early, but just struggling with this constant countered pressure thus far.
Yeah, they've been bombarding the Warriors so far, and they have the ball again as they look for more near the midfield line. Robert Iverson. Ball is loose on the turf. They scrum for it rugby style, and the Warriors come away with it. Griffin Smith, sophomore middie, first year at the varsity level. There's Jacob Gershon. Called his sister's name a lot. He's the brother of the Hall girls netminder, who stood unbelievably tall in the opening game that we broadcast this afternoon. Won by the Conard girls 13-4. They were quite dominant, and if it weren't for the Hall girls netminder, that would have been one heck of a rout. Griffin Smith goes cross to Kyler Cubbage. Kevin Carr back of the net. Little spin in front, the person of Chris Mons. As he works against Tyler Granger. Good defense by the Chieftains. Keeping Hall from attempting a quality shot on goal. Tyler Cubbage plays much bigger than his size, according to head coach Von Meyerhauser. And his hockey coach, Brian Cannon, would say the same thing during the wintertime. Here's Cubbage again. Swings it to Spencer Witter. Witter, a nice spin move, but didn't have the angle. And now a nice interception. And here comes Richem. He is extremely quick. Nice pass. In front, shot, score. Tick-tack goal. And Henry Neidel able to finish it, and it's 4-0.
Neidel taking advantage of some sloppy passing from the Warriors. Passes need to go high, especially against a team who can score like Conard can. We have four goals already. We're barely halfway through the first quarter. And another note on that last possession, Conard getting much more physical on defense than Hall has. Conard pressing and forcing just some sloppy passes, some low passes. It's good to bounce a shot. It's not great to bounce a pass. And Hall paying for it dearly, down 4-0 here, still barely midway through the first.
Exactly right, with still 5:19 to play here in the opening quarter. Patrick Corcoran leading the attack in the zone. Here's O'Connor spinning away from traffic as he cuts back behind the net. Being watched by Evan Duzan. You know that name from Frank Robinson's football team. Here's O'Connor back outside. This is McCormick. Long shot goes off the post. Jack Girundo, 3-year starter, all-league performer, just missing. And a multi-goal effort in the victory over Norwich Free Academy on Saturday, a game that was played here at McKee Stadium. Nice pass from McCormick, shot was blocked. And now we have a flag down on the field.
It looked like a cross check there. And Girundo looking for an even dozen goals on that last shot. Didn't miss by much, right off the post. And we are awaiting the call as it appears Hall will play a man down here, which is not what Coach Von Meyerhauser wants to see. Down 4-0.
And it will be for 2 minutes and an irreplaceable penalty as it's called. Just joining us, Hollerback, O'Connor, and Tubai Nidal have the Chieftains in front. 4-0. We've played 7.5 minutes in the opening quarter. Nightcap of our Lacrosse Day doubleheader. Happy to be with you on WHC-TV Channel 5 and online at WHC-TV.org. This is McCormick.
Thank you.
Passes right side. Gets the pass back. Long shot. He scores. What a shot from the 25-yard line. And the score goes to 5-0 with 4:13 to go. A
little bit of confusion there from Newman. It looked as if he had saved it. And as you mentioned, a long, long shot that time. Newman seems a bit befuddled. And if I'm Coach Von Meyerhauser, right now I'm looking for any sign of hope, whether it's from the faceoff X, better passing, tighter defense, but right now 5-0 Conard, all the momentum going the Chieftains' way.
And just the thing too that Newman had those two glorious big saves early, stop the breakaway opportunity, or this one could really be getting out of hand.
Okay.
Drew Holler back.
I'm just moving this thing.
Big assist guy for Bill Conard's team.
Okay.
Passes on the wing to Nidal. His shot goes wide. You know you're having a good first quarter when you're bidding for a first quarter hat trick. It's something that Gwen Geisler, throughout the course of the game, was able to do for Conard. The girls' victory, which came earlier 13-4. Perimeter passing by the Chieftains. Now back behind the net for Andrew Hollerback. Helped as always by Bill Watson, fine public address announcer, telling us a couple of seniors have been added to the attack, including Ian Garrity. It is their senior day celebration out here. And head coach Condon will try to incorporate all the different seniors as times and situations will dictate. Paul Wilson on the field for the Chieftains. Sophomore midfielder. Passes to Grant O'Connor, younger brother of Jack. He faked the shot nicely and got it down to Grant O'Connor, Hollerback, didn't have an angle. Back outside to Paul Wilson. Very deliberate here as well. Part of it is they're looking for the right shot. The other part of it is probably some good sportsmanship, already realizing that this game could get out of hand pretty quickly. High and wide with that shot. Of course, on the other hand, too, The unenviable task of Hall coming in here facing the Conard team that comes off a 15-goal loss to Glastonbury. So they're going to take out their frustrations from that one.
Absolutely. And the worst possible matchup, the worst possible time for the Warriors as Conard off that 15-goal loss now, as you mentioned, pregame 13th in the Class O rankings, and the top 16 will make the tournament. So Conard looking to impress the committee tonight, and a big win over their big rival could go a long way.
So certainly a lot to play for here on senior night for the homestanding Chieftains. Hall, on the other hand, losers of seven straight, trying to hang in there as best they can. Shot from the angle, and a nice save by Newman. He tried to go top shelf on him, but Harrison Newman, first year in lacrosse, has played very well. If you follow Hall football, you know that he's an offensive lineman for Frank Robinson's team. Off the turnover, Conard on the attack. They had a possible 3-on-1 down low, but didn't take it. And the shot goes off the crossbar. So two close misses, as well as the five opening stanza goals. And the clock is stopped with 81 ticks on the clock. Matt McCormick, Jack Gerundo, and Ben Hollerback check into the game for the Chieftains. And the pass goes to Jack Gerundo. Three-year starter and a senior, all-league performer a year ago. Back behind the net, this is Andrew Hollerback. Back outside, Gerundo. All on the perimeter. Back out top, Nidal for Gerundo. Under 40 seconds to play here in the opening quarter. Long shot, score! A bullet drive by Gerundo. And he's able to beat Newman. And that adds to the scoreboard for the Hall Warriors.
Gerundo showed us the speed a couple of minutes ago with that laser off the post. This time he straightened it out enough. And Newman, that was just me versus you to Gerundo. And Gerundo comes out on top. And Conard continuing to run away with this one. Now 6-0, not even out of the first.
Everything but the extra point thus far here at McKee Stadium in West Hartford. Conard just continues to dominate on the faceoffs. Pat Corcoran, another hockey player on the field as we have the flag down. Want to send a special shout out to Pat. He was a volunteer cameraman for us during the boys basketball game at Conard back in February. Want to thank him for a job well done. And obviously the senior midfielder has played particularly well this year for Bill Condon and company. Clock is stopped, 24 ticks to play here in the opening quarter. It'll be Conard possession as they put the ball in play, led by McCormick. Faked his shot, passes it right side. He's swinging around, back of the net. This is Gerundo with it. Back out top, McCormick fakes the shot, passes right side. 8 seconds to go. Clock's a factor. And that's going to do it for the opening quarter. So 12 minutes in the books in our nightcap here at McKee Stadium. Dominant effort by Conard thus far. They lead it 6-0 at the end of one. The War Chief Sports Council would like to thank our many fine sponsors, including those at the all-state level, Keating Insurance, Maca Plumbing and Heating, Reed and Reach PC, Counselors at Law, ESPN, the Conard and Hall PTO, and Mr. and Mrs. Jonathan Gibson. Thanks to one and all for your continued support of the War Chief Sports Council. And a reminder, we'll be back with you for our baseball coverage this coming Monday, the 23rd. We'll be out at the University of Hartford Stadium. Nice venue there for the Mayor's Cup game. Conard against Hall, battle number 2 on the season. 4:30 will be first pitch, so join us on Channel 5. And if you can't make it out to the game or see us on TV. You can always join us online at whc-tv.org. Jeff Kaplowitz will join us for the broadcast, as he did a few weeks back for the softball matchup. And it's the second baseball matchup of the season.
Is it good?
As Hall won the first one. But Hall did not win when they played in the Mayor's Cup last year. Neil Kelly thrown out and tried to steal home to end the game. And Conard was able to hold on for the victory in Ty Bon Giovanni's final regular season game as the head coach of the Chieftains. Obviously a dominant effort so far for the Chieftains, but other thoughts, Adam, as you look back at this first quarter?
The Warriors need to improve their passing and their aggression on the defensive side. You mentioned Von Meyerhauser looking for physicality from all sports. Well, he's not getting it from his own team so far.
And the first shot of the second quarter by Matt McCormick, and he's able to score. Nidal gets the assist. And that's the extra point, as it were, to make it 7-0 Chieftains as they start the second quarter right where they left off at the end of one. So McCormick has two, Nidal has two, Gerundo, O'Connor, and Hollerback all on the score sheet this afternoon thus far for Bill Condon's team. Conard on the year, they've outscored the opposition 142-136, so they have given up defensively their share of goals. But again, 20 of those came in their recent loss to Glastonbury. Phil Simplicio put the ball in play. Phil, a senior defender, football and basketball player, and quite the vocal leader on all the teams that he plays for, no doubt about it. He always makes his presence felt, no matter which sport he's playing.
For camera three.
It's Jack O'Connor looking to set up. Goes back behind the net for Nidal. He plays catch with O'Connor. Now back outside. They fake the pass to the left and give it back right side to O'Connor. Hollerback had it behind the net. Substitution is made as they get Grant O'Connor on the field. He replaces Robert Iverson. Grant O'Connor plays catch with Paul Wilson. Swing it right side for Jack O'Connor. Back of the net for Hollerback. It's very interesting how in this sport, when they're in the set offense as they are right now, looks very much like you would set up in a hockey power play.
Exactly, just a ton of perimeter passing, hoping for an opening, hoping for some sort of leak in the defense. Hall switching to more of a matchup zone here, going away from more of the straight man-to-man they had for much of the first. As a shot goes wide there, O'Connor will track it down in the corner. And again, Hall unable to come up with ground balls, their own end on the defensive end, unable to clear the zone as Conard again maintains possession, looking to just build on this already enormous lead.
Grant O'Connor set all this up by doing a nice job forcing and controlling the turnover. And as we talked about with the Hall girls team, the boys team continues throughout their losing streak just to have all kinds of difficulties with the turnovers. And again, in defense of both the Hall teams that we're seeing here today, first the girls and then the boys, there's not a lot of veteran presence. Both young teams that will continue to grow, continue to get better. It's just when they're matched up against superior opposition, and I'm sure they'll be the first to admit that, just looks worse than it is. Good job of forcing the turnover. The Hall Warriors, Griffin Smith speeds down for the Warriors. Hands it off to Jack McHale. McHale and Smith, two underclassmen who are going to be leaders of this team for the next couple of years. Pass was intercepted, picked off. Aiden Stabnik on the defense. Gets it ahead to Jack O'Connor. Spins out of trouble. Double teams as he comes to the near sideline and gets it back outside to Matt McCormick, and they'll reset. Paul Wilson checks out of the game. And he's going to be replaced by Kiernan Boyd. So Bill Condon doing a nice job of getting another senior onto the field. Here's Hollerback. Swings it left side, thinking about the shot that time and not taking it. Here's Bryce Williams on the field, another senior. McCormick back outside to Gerundo. Long shot and right in. Basket held by Harrison Newman. One bright spot is Newman, I would think. I mean, he's made at least four saves here this afternoon, so it could be worse than the score is right now as we have a timeout being taken.
Oh, you mentioned it. Newman has kept this from being possibly a double-digit deficit already for Hall. And you mentioned Condon getting those seniors onto the field. That's a luxury you have when you're up 7-0. And for Coach Von Meyerhauser, he's got 14 seniors himself, and at some point he might want to get them on the field so they can see some somewhat meaningful time in their final game, not as meaningful when you're down 7 goals. But you mentioned the youth of the Warriors and Griffin Smith on that previous possession before the turnover, doing what any smart player at any level should do on that clear, which is just running to green, showing speed, outrunning several Conard attackmen, getting the ball into the attack zone, something we have not seen much of from Hall today, as this game has been significantly controlled by Conard on the attack. So Smith showing a possible bright spot for Hall next year, as he and 14 underclassmen for Von Meyerhauser will return.
Talk about time of possession. It's a statistic that is given a lot of weight in the sport of football, and you're seeing it more and more in hockey with the hockey analytics. Now, obviously, plays a big role here in lacrosse. Obviously, your best defense could be a good offense. I mean, if you have the ball, it's just simple reality. The other team can't score.
Well, they mentioned in football that turnovers will win or lose you games depending on how you look at it. And the same thing goes for lacrosse, as Hall has already turned the ball over several times and on that last possession when Smith was just unable to connect with his attackman after that clear, as Conard again turned it into another offensive possession.
And they get on the scoreboard. Nice long-range shot by Kyler Cubbage, the senior. He's a left-hander, and he scored from just inside the 25-yard line. So a man who didn't play lacrosse a year ago, the defensive stalwarts on Brian Cannon's hockey team. Bunch of assists, not a lot of goals for Von Meyerhauser's team, but he looked like a goal scorer on that one for sure.
You mentioned Cubbage, the left-hander, scoring that on the run from the right side, showing a little bit of ambidextrousness on that one as Paul finally gets on the board here, really midway through the second, as they finally maintain a possession here, as Smith now maintains in the offensive zone. And right as I said, that another turnover as another sloppy pass, low pass, and Hall needs to work on hitting their offensive players in the chest, sort of like a playing catch in baseball. You gotta hit them high, because if you go low, wet grass, it's gonna roll.
Always aiming for that chest of the first baseman or the base that you're aiming to throw to, and the same thing bodes well here if you're able to do so. 7-1 the score with 6.5 to play in the half. As surprise, surprise, Conard back on offense yet again. It's being led by Jack Gerundo. He's trying to outrun Kanega back behind the net. Passes on the wing back outside to Jack O'Connor, being bothered by Duzan. Evan Duzan, an interesting player, vocal leader for the Hall team, and one of the better players for Frank Robinson's football team. O'Connor, as Bill Condon talked about, has just tremendous stamina. as he and Gerundo and company, they do a lot of running around, that's for sure. Shot was blocked, but Hall can't control the possession. It's maintained by McCormick and the Chieftains. Swings it left side, here's Hollerback. Runs to his right. Tries to escape from Jordan Weinstock. There's O'Connor on the wing. Long shot, and that goes wide. Jack Gerundo bidding for his second of the evening's contest. He'll be put in play by the Chieftains back behind the net. There's Hollerback. Tries to spin away from Weinstock. Now back to Jack O'Connor. He's being harassed there by Kevin Carr. Back outside, they reset. John Gibbons on the field for the Chieftains. Junior midfielder. Gerundo, some pretty spin moves. Nice pass. And it just eluded Bryce Williams, the intended recipient that time. And Hall again can't control a loose ball. That's at least three times today where they've played good defense and just can't control the loose ball. McCormick, nice pass. Shot goes high and wide. Gerundo bidding for what would have been his 13th goal of the season. Some of the scores that Conard has put up, a lot of their bigger scores have come lately. Double digits against Norwich Free Academy as well as East Lyme. 15 goals in the win against Avon, 15 more against Ram. So they're really getting the offense in sync, and today certainly no exception.
Well, they've already reached 10 goals nine times this season, and they're on pace to reach that by the end of the first half, as it is now. And we see things getting a little bit chippy between these two here lately. A lot of cross checks lately, as the emotion, especially for Hall, down six goals, might be starting to boil over here. And if I'm Coach Von Meyerhaus, I'm telling my guys to calm down. This is just a game. It might be the rivalry of the season, the biggest, most important regular season game in terms of just the emotion, but you have to keep your cool down by six, show some maturity, especially for the younger players who are going to be back next season. The seniors have to show them the maturity that they want to turn over when they graduate, as Hall, again, as we've seen the last couple of possessions, unable to clear the zone, unable to field ground balls, and Conner taking full advantage, just keeping the ball consistently in the offensive zone, as Hall looking for any signs of offensive life here.
Do you think that's a product of nerves, the fact that they're not chasing down those balls? Do you think that's a product of frustration as well, that after you make great defensive stands like that, and then all of a sudden you have your opportunity and they just get flustered by it?
It's some of both. You've been chasing this attack nearly the entire game, and especially with Conard, you mentioned the stamina of these guys running circles around Hall at times. So Hall, when they're able to keep Conard off the board, you're trying to just overcome all that exhaustion and wait for that reserve to kick in, and it doesn't seem to be coming, as Conard winning loose ball after loose ball.
And the shot by O'Connor goes high and wide. Clock stopped. 3:30 play here in the opening half. Certainly a rivalry that's been one-sided over the last few years. Conard winning four consecutive times, including 15-7 a year ago. The last really close match was 2012. Single goal victory for the Chieftains that day when they defeated the Warriors by the count of 11 to 10. 7-1 the score. Conard led 6-0 at the end of one, and the teams have traded goals here in the second. So it's much more defensive oriented. Nice save by Newman. Gets the pass ahead to Gershom. And now a whistle and a stoppage as well. 2:53 to go. A timeout taken by the Warriors. The War Chief Sports Council would like to thank our many fine sponsors, including those at the captain's level. And they include Hartford Distributors, Franklin Fine Beers, Cork and Bottle, the Babe Ruth Organization, and Coastal Tool and Rob Ludkin at the all-conference level, Allied Printing and the Hartford Golf Club, as well as the varsity level. The many fine sponsors there include Low Tide Photography, Cork and Bottle, Blue Plate, Fast Eddie, Dave Newman Photography, West Hartford Youth Basketball, the West Hartford Boys Travel Basketball Team, Open Arm Christian Ministries, Final Cut Barbershop, Edward Connors Insurance, Stanley and Elaine Phillips, Beth Barry Brown from the William Ravis Agency, and West Hartford Girls Lacrosse. Thanks to one and all for your continued support of the War Chief Sports Council, the official booster club of both Hall and Conard High Schools. Pete Lammer, Adam Ryder with you here, along with our fine WHC-TV Channel 5 crew. Jen and Meredith and Diana do a great job for us, as well as our volunteer photographers. Appreciate everybody's efforts here today and keep us on the air and on time. 7-1 the score, off the timeout, and Conard back on the attack, and it's Andrew Holler back with the ball. Passes it off to Jordan Dorfman, and Newman controls. So 125 thwarts another, and Hall back on the attack, led by Duzan. This is McHale, down low, nice passing, and they set up a man wide open to the left of the netminder, Carson, and the shot goes wide. So even when they set it up well, unfortunately for the Warriors, they just couldn't convert.
Whether you're down six, whether you're up six, inside of 5 yards, one-on-one off a pass like that, you have to finish no matter what level you are at, especially when you are struggling like Hall has to maintain possessions and maintain the ball. So we have yet another turnover as Hall missing a golden opportunity to get just a little bit closer as we see the physicality again picking up on the far side of the field. As it looks like Hall will finally maintain the possession. The question is, how long will they keep it this time?
Teams exchanging turnovers as Hall sets up for what they hope is a second consecutive goal. Conard led 6-0 at the end of one, added to that early here in the second. We're up 7-0 before Hall finally, in the person of Kyler Cubbage, able to dent the scoreboard. There's McHale with a long shot, but it's blocked at the defense. Kevin Carr tries to chase it down. And Hall's going to maintain possession. Buck 20 to go here until halftime, and the clock running. Heavy hit on the play, and a flag down. Dorfman hitting McHale that time. Thought he's back on the football field.
Looks like Dorfman would be guilty of a cross check. And if you're Hall right now, especially at the end of the period here, you want to take full advantage of the, I believe it's second man down opportunity they've had, looking to get just a little bit closer, especially with Conard starting to pick up the physicality, a luxury they have up by six. You want to keep chipping away, keeping that pressure on Conard. Because the longer they keep it close, the more that pressure is going to build as Conard looks to maintain their Class L playoff hopes.
1 minute.
Minute to play. With the Warriors a man up. Quick passing by the Warriors. And the shot was easily denied by Tyler Carson. First year starter in goal is Carson. Very athletic kid. Again, another kid off the football field. Conard with possession. They'll look to kill the clock here. Hall obviously wants to get the ball as quickly as possible and try to generate one more scoring opportunity. Jack O'Connor and his friends, including Matt McCormick, doing a nice job of keep away. Down to 12 seconds to go here in the opening half. Here's McCormick speeding away from Cubbage. Here's McCormick, shoots and scores with 1.1 seconds to go. As McCormick makes it an 8-1 game.
As McCormick reaches that hat trick just before the half. And for Hall, just a disastrous last few minutes, going from a man-up opportunity, not getting a great look on goal, another turnover leading to yet another goal for Conard, who increases the lead back to 7.
And you hear the horn sound behind us, signifying the end of the first half. So after outscoring Hall 6-0 in the first quarter, they get 2 out of the 3 goals scored here in the second. And we go to the intermission with Conard comfortably in front of Hall, 8-1, as you continue to watch West Hartford High School sports as presented by the War Chief Sports Council here on WHC-TV Channel 5.
Are you sure to the left-hand side?
Right.
Huh?
Right.
Hey, no, bro, Renata. You must also slide for this. Don't take camera in zoom. Camera one will be. Happen to you. And scoreboard to get.
Okay. Don't drop angle.
पण मी बनव बघताना काढणार सर मी न बघताना काढणार पिंटी पण त्याने कॅमेरा दिसतोय अभी तो कैमरा तरी अब बोल रहा है म्हणजे चालू झालंय का
हो चालू आउट कर
फ्रेम ठेवायची आहे काय
नाही ना अनुभव नको आता
play back underway as we rejoin you here at Robert J. McKee Stadium in West Hartford. Pete Lamoureux, Adam Ryder back with you as the Conard Chieftains have an 8-1 lead over their crosstown rivals, scoring 6 in the first, 2 in the second. Hall's lone goal in the second, courtesy of Kyler Cubbage. Harrison Newman very strong in net for Hall. We're just talking off air that this could be 12 or 13 on the scoreboard for Conard at this point, but not the case. Good passing through the midfield, leading to an opportunity for Jordan Weinstock to set up in the attack zone for the Hall Warriors. Weinstock, a receiver on the football team for Frank Robinson and company. He's been asked by Coach Ben Von Mayerhauser to assume a leadership role on this team, which, according to the coach, he's done very well. Pushed to the ground that time is Weinstock. So he was belted from behind by Nate Richem. Nate comes out. One of the last times I saw Nate Richem on this field, did he score, Bill Watson, about 6 touchdowns that day? 6 TDs as Conard went 60 plus in the football win. Yeah, upwards of 400 yards. Just a dynamic running back for Matt Sersosimo's team. And you can see the football psyche in Richem from time to time here on the lacrosse field. Nice passing by Hall, but a good save by the netminder Tyler Carson. It was a great setup and a better set.
As Richem going out on that lost possession called for what looked like a check to the back, but Hall unable to convert on the man up, as now Conard having some trouble clearing the ball as Hall will get a shot here, and they, it looked like it went in, but I guess it went off the side of the net as now Conard again unable to clear.
And the turnovers starting to mount here early in the third quarter for the Chieftains. There's Cubbage trying to spin away from pressure. Jack McHale with his pass on the left to Chris Mons. Eight-one the score. 9:50 to play here in the third. Richam out of the game. His fellow tailback, Jordan Dorfman, dishing out some of the punishment from a defensive perspective. Here's Mons. Tried to center it, no angle for Griffin Smith, and he backs it out. Mons called the quickest attacker by his head coach. He's now at Spencer Witter. And the shot goes long. Good hustle there. And Hall maintains possession. You're looking for moral victories? Certainly for Hall. It's been almost an even contest if you throw away the first 12 minutes. At least they've come back into a more competitive mode here.
They've slowed the attack significantly since then. I'm not sure how much of that is Conard slowly backing off, not wanting to really embarrass Hall too badly, showing a little bit of sportsmanship there. But Hall has shown a little bit more defensive pressure. Conard being much more aggressive side early on. Hall fighting back a little bit more, both on the offensive and defensive sides here, as a shot goes wide, as Conard will look to clear. But
great release, great outlet pass. Conard on the attack. Pass in front, picked off by the goaltender, Newman. Great play as O'Connor was set up. He would have had a wide open net for an easy goal. They tried for their second tic-tac goal of the night, as I steal that from Jack Edwards, the Simsbury native, longtime veteran play-by-play announcer of the Boston Bruins on Nesson. Remember what my mom always says, no such thing as an original thought. Back behind the net, this is Kevin Carr. Faked his pass and maintains possession. And watched by Tyler Granger. Called his name a couple of times in the first half. Number one matchup guy is Granger. As he gets set to play next year at Western New England College in Springfield. We swing it around the perimeter. This is Griffin Smith off the pass from McHale. Smith tries to elude A.J. Speranza. And back outside. Good defense by the Conard Chieftains. In particular, Speranza, the CIAC scholar athlete. This is Carr. Extended possession time by the Warriors. But again, most of their work conducted on the perimeter. Trying to screenshot that time. Tried to use Granger as a screen and tried to beat the goaltender low, but Conard have nothing of it and a great release. And here they come the other way, led by Paul Wilson. And they muff the pass. One of the cases where Neidl was looking to shoot before he received the pass. Richam back on the field. Nate with a shot, and it's blocked at the defense, and it hit the defender. I think he caught it off his foot. Is that right, Bill? Andrew Crivetti is the injured Hall Warrior. And luckily, he is up, taking his helmet off, and he's going to come off the field and will be replaced by Giovanni Garcia. So while you'll never want to see the injury, at least it gives the head coach an opportunity to incorporate another senior into the attack.
Crivetti sacrificing his body, soaking up that shot. It looked as if Richmond faked it, But it's just a case of a shot coming out so quickly and bouncing right back to Richam as Conard will maintain possession as Crivetti hopefully is okay. As you mentioned, it will give the senior Garcia a chance to get some playing time against a rival like Conard as Richam now maintains behind the hall net.
5.5 to play here in the third. Game that was 8-1 at halftime has remained so. Richam has shot and Newman has the answer that time. Brilliant save again by the goaltender who unofficially has at least a half a dozen stops in this contest. Seen great goaltending on both sides, not only in this game, but in the girls' game earlier as well. Scheid and Gershom in the girls' contest really put on a clinic in terms of their net-minding prowess here this afternoon. Mons has the ball for the Warriors. Jordan Weinstock back into the action for the Hall Warriors. Here's McHale. He's being watched by the defender Iverson, who's back on the field for Conard. Here's Kubich. He's the lone goal scorer today for the Hall Warriors. McHale directing traffic for Hall. Spencer Witter trying to use his size to his advantage. He's 6'4", 210. Spins through traffic. But again, good defense. Drives him back behind the net. Talking about Witter, big presence during the fall for Frank Robinson's team as their starting defensive end. Certainly can rush the passer. Bad angle shot taken that time by Carr goes wide. That was a low percentage shot for sure.
Nearly from the goal line extended. I don't know what angle Carr saw, but you're down by 7. You got to take some risks in Carr more than up to the task on that one. Thankfully, the backup was in place as the Warriors will maintain possession here as a surprising defensive battle is broken out here as we are scoreless nearly two-thirds of the way through this third quarter. As a shot goes wide and we have a penalty on the play, we will await the call.
That was Kevin Carr taking the attempted shot that went wide. And really, when you look at a lot of the Hall opportunities that they've had here today so far, very few have come from good angles. And the ones that they've had in terms of better angles have come from far out. They've come from distance. And that shot was a fall-away shot taken from the 25-yard line.
Conard's done an excellent job of running the Warriors out of the short mid areas that Hall defensively has struggled to keep Conard out of. We saw nearly just 15 seconds into this quarter, all 6'2", 220 pounds of Pat Corcoran found a spot 5 yards in front of Harrison Newman, was just unable to connect. That might have been the best opportunity of the quarter for either squad, but unfortunately Corcoran unable to connect as we remain scoreless as we go under 3 minutes here in the third. Hall maintaining possession, passing looking much crisper here than it did in either of the first two quarters, as the turnovers have gone significantly down for the Warriors and up for the Chieftains, who have hit a surprising impasse on the offensive side here.
Nice. Conard victory would allow them to match their record from a year ago. Interesting save right there by the goaltender Carson. He had the ball deflect up into the pocket of his uniform. Great opportunity for Hall and an incredible save by the senior goaltender. First year starter, and he's played well beyond his lack of playing time throughout his career.
Would we consider that a top 10 or a not top 10 moment? He had no idea where that ball was for several seconds and wound up in the most unlikely of places, but it's all the same for Conard. It's a save, as Hall unable to crack the score sheet here as we go under 2 minutes with Conard back on the offensive possession and a missed opportunity right in front. Another near tic-tac goal just missed, but Hall again unable to gather the loose ball in the far corner as a mini rugby scrum is now broken out. And this is where emotions can take over. Large groups, a dangerous environment as Hall finally comes away with it.
The previous opportunity, McCormick had set up Hollerback. And there's a goal for the Hall Warriors, and they finally break into the score sheet. Chris Mons with the goal. Quick attacker, the junior, gets the goal. And that makes it 9-2 at the 1:23 mark of this third quarter.
Hall finally converting a ground ball in their favor, clearing the zone successfully. They didn't try to pass their way out. That's what they struggled with early on, trying to pass their way out of pressure. In some cases, it's just best to run to green. And that's exactly what they did there as we have our second goal for the Warriors here as they look for any sign of life here as we go under now 13 minutes left in perhaps the season
for the Hall Warriors. And we talked about before with Conard, they were 10-6 a year ago, lost to McMahon in the first round of the Class L tourney, and they could match a 10-6 mark with a win here tonight, and then I'm sure be on their way to the tournament as well. They started 13th in the rankings. As Adam alluded to, they take the top 16. They should be good to go for postseason competition. 35 seconds to go. Ben Hollerback passes to McCormick. Back outside to Gerundo. Looking to set up that perfect shot and a great play on the bounce by O'Connor. And he shoots and it's off the side of the net and retrieved by Newman. Great scoop that time by O'Connor. Now Hall in transition with 14 seconds to go in the third quarter as Kanaga looks to speed away. Gets inside the 30-yard line, gets his pass to Weinstock. 2 seconds to go, ball gets away, and that'll do it for play here in the third quarter. Score at the end of three, Conard 8 and Hall 2. And we'll come back with fourth quarter action as we continue our presentation of West Hartford High School sports here on WHC-TV Channel 5 as presented by the War Chief Sports Council. And the aforementioned council would like to thank our many fine sponsors, including those at the all-state level. Keating Insurance Agency, MACA Plumbing and Heating, Reed and Reage PC Counselors at Law, ESPN, Conard and Hall PTO, and Mr. and Mrs. Jonathan Gibson. Thanks to one and all for your continued support of the official booster clubs of West Hartford High School Sports, the War Chief Sports Council, in association with Conard and Hall High Schools. So, three quarters of the books, 8-2 as we go to the fourth. What do you expect for the final stanza?
What I'd like to see from both coaches at this point, especially from Von Meyerhauser, is to look towards the future. You have 14 non-seniors who will be back next season. See what they will give you. Balance the playing time well. Give their seniors their moment in the sun, their final sign-off. But give the underclassmen some playing time as well. And for Coach Condon, any seniors who have not been out there yet, get them out there now. It is still a 6-goal game. There might have been a bit of an offensive stall there in that third quarter as they finally go scoreless, holding a great job defensively. Harrison Newman especially, who has shown amazing improvement just in the last 12 minutes. But if I'm Coach Condon, get any senior out there who is not now on senior night.
Off the face, here to begin play in the fourth and final quarter. Patrick Corcoran has it. Gives to John O'Connor. Jack down the right side. Good defense there by the Warriors, especially in the person of Giovanni Garcia. Conard back behind the net. Pass in front, shot, score. Beautiful setup to Andrew Hollerback that time. And Andrew able to finish it off. And the senior captain and two-year starter on the score sheet again. So he scored the first goal of the game, and he adds the ninth tally this afternoon for the Chieftains to put him team in front by the count of 9-2. Pretty feed that time, all on the part of Jack O'Connor.
Absolutely. O'Connor staying tall, absorbing the contact, keeping its head up, and finding across the field, which is a difficult pass to make at any level. Again, absorbing that contact and finding Hollerback for an easy goal from short distance is a major check there, jars the ball loose. But again, that play entirely set up by O'Connor. Hollerback, the fortunate recipient, getting his name on the score sheet, as you mentioned, for the second time tonight.
So you talked about the big name players for this Conard team hitting the score sheet early, and they continue to do so here in the fourth quarter. Gerundo a shot, and that goes wide. And his hands go to the top of his head in frustration. He had some wide open space, top corner, on Newman, and he just missed it.
Gerundo knows he missed that one, given way too much space by this Warrior defense. Allowed a running start, almost Happy Gilmore style, and just uncorked it just a little bit wide, and he knows he missed it. But again, up by 7 goals, a little less pressure than, say, in a tie ball game, or especially for Hull being down by 7. But Gerundo given way too much space on that one. And if I'm Von Meyerhauser, I'm wondering, where was the defense on that last shot?
Always good to get the Happy Gilmore reference in there. Especially one of the only films you'll ever see with a Hartford Whalers pennant hanging from the wall. Right in front, shot, score. Henry Neidel. And that's the third of the game for him. And the Chieftains increase their lead to 10-2. And now I think we're going to see some wholesale changes here for the Conard Chieftains.
Yeah, now with an 8-goal lead for Coach Condon to play with, even more pressure off of his shoulders, much, much more freedom to get. The seniors who haven't seen as much playing time in their Neidel. Now the second Chieftain with a hat trick tonight. And we mentioned Conard entered this game 5 double-digit goal scorers. They have all hit the score sheet. And for McCormick, that hat trick gave him 20 goals on the season. So now Conard with 4 20-goal scorers on the season. As we have a timeout on the field here with 10:23 to go in the final stanza.
And that gives us a chance to thank our participating sponsors to the War Chief Sports Council. At the captain's level, Hartford Distributors, Franklin Fine Beers, Cork and Bottle, the Babe Ruth Organization, and Coastal Tool and Rob Ludgen. And at the all-conference level, Allied Printing, along with the Hartford Golf Club. Thanks to one and all for your continued support of West Hartford High School sports and specifically the War Chief Sports Council. Great job done by the council, led by Paul McConnell and Dennis Swanton. They do such a great job, and all the members of the council as well. And I'd like to thank our fine friends at WHC-TV, all the volunteers, making broadcasts like this possible. Couldn't do it without the help of all our volunteer camera people as well. 10-2 the score, 10:23 time remaining here in the fourth and final quarter. As we get set for the faceoff between Patrick Corcoran of Conard and Jordan Weinstock of the Hall Warriors. And here come the Chieftains on the attack once again. And while they've cleared the bench in some regards, Jack O'Connor remains out there. Trying to fight through a double team. It's stolen away by the Warriors. And here's Weinstock speeding away for Hall. Watched by Hollerback on the far side. Does a good job to get by him at midfield. His pass is deflected. Loose on the field. Battled for and controlled by Hall. Here comes an opportunity and the shot. And that deflected wide. Good shot from in front, 20-yard line, tried to bounce it, and it just went wide of the cage that time.
Just a little wild there, but fortunately for Hall, the backup will maintain the possession. And something to note here as we are now in the fourth, the conditioning of both of these squads, we've been hustling after ground balls all day long. A lot of physical play in this one between both squads, and it's just a testament to the conditioning of just how well in shape these players are. But again, you mentioned the starter still being out there for the Chieftains, up by 8 goals here. You're starting to think about the playoffs now. You got to get those guys out of there before running risk of an injury.
Spencer Witter, we talked about in the third quarter, able to score for Hall. Get them on the scoreboard for the third time in this contest. And it comes with 9:04 to go here in this fourth and final quarter. And we'll get set for the faceoff. Now Graham Kennedy on the field for Hall. He's gonna take the draw. And it's won by Corcoran and Conard. Big shot and they score. Patrick Corcoran's happy about that. Not a guy that hits the score sheet a lot. But you talk about an individual effort that time. You win the draw, come all the way down, and able to beat the netminder for the quick score.
Sometimes the best solutions are the simplest. Corcoran just his second goal of the season. We mentioned his name at the beginning of the third, finding a home for himself in the middle of that whole defense, and this time he decided, I'm going to do it myself, and I'm going to score just my second goal of the season, as Conard getting the goal right back as the lead grows back to 9, as Corcoran again controlling the faceoff.
Erring pass by the Warriors. Kevin Carr dives for it, showing good effort that time. But it's going to elude him, and Conard will get possession. ...11-3 the score. 8-10 to play in the fourth and final quarter. Big time collision at midfield. Leads to a chance. All alone they score. Back to back all goals for Spencer Witter. Good passing by the Hall Warriors. And Witter gets his second within a minute or so.
As the defensive battle that took over the third has been replaced by much of what we saw in the first quarter, although Hall equal to the task with Conard, as Conard, again, that 6-0 first quarter, as Hall here, their second goal of the quarter. We've already had 5 goals here in the final quarter, and we are not even 4 minutes down. It took us really the entire third before we got one, as some signs of offense here late from both squads, as Hall looking to keep this from being a blowout, and Conard looking for any momentum to carry them towards the state playoffs.
Physical plays by Hall leading to more opportunities here. Playing with some passion, and then they lose the ball. McHale lost it. Conard back in the other direction. This is Andrew Hollerbach. Back of the net, Jack O'Connor still on the field. 7.5 to play, 11-4 the score. After this scoring uprising so far early in the fourth quarter. Sam LaFonte checks out. Ian Garrity is another senior on the field for the Conard squad. as Gerundo looks to lead the attack here for Conard. Tough pass to handle by Hollerbach as he battles with Cubbage back behind the net, and it will stay Conard possession. Very few bad passes today by the Chieftains. Quite precise. And in front, and Newman able to pick it off and get it ahead to Weinstock. Weinstock speeds through midfield. Down the right sideline. Thought about cutting in front, but a great job defensively that time by the Chieftains. Ian Gearty doing the job. Tyler Carson, the long pass ahead to O'Connor. Pete Caron was on the field. He checks off right in front, the shot, and it deflected high over the net. Good opportunity. And standing tall that time was Newman. Here's Weinstock for the Warriors. Passes it ahead to Kyler Cubbage. Crossfield pass goes to Witter. He's looking for a fourth quarter hat trick if he can connect again for the Hall team. Back of the net for McHale. Here's Griffin Smith. Again, one of the guys, Griffin Smith, will be somebody that they count on coming up in the next year or two. As Ben Von Meyerhauser continues to grow his program. Bounced opportunity goes high and wide. And Hall's going to maintain possession. 5:15, time to play in the fourth quarter. Great steal. And here comes Conard the other way. Simplicio looking to set up Bryce Williams that time. And Simplicio with a shot, and that goes off the side of the net. He's one of the spiritual and vocal leaders of this team, and you can hear the applause from the crowd. He's one of the fan favorites, whether he's playing football, basketball, or lacrosse. Just has one of those infectious personalities. And a real, real take charge type of kid. Off to Bates College, as Bill Watson reminds me. I think we're having a goal change, as Ramsey Henderson, the sophomore, replaces Tyler Carson. So 43 minutes of excellence today for Carson. Allows just 4 goals. Good bounce back for him after the 20-goal debacle against Glastonbury. Back behind the net, Matt McCormick. As a spin away from Cubbage, centering pass in front, they score. Pretty pass right there, and finished off by Jordan Dorfman. And at 4:03 of the fourth, it's 12-4.
As Dorfman getting just his second goal of the year there, off a pretty feed inside, as Hall again allowing Chieftains inside that short yardage marker, unable to force them outside. Chieftains getting position after position inside. It's like boxing out in basketball, and Conard's winning every battle, it seems, thus far. One of the big reasons why they have run away with this game almost from the get-go.
Yeah, good description, and certainly they've got more of the loose balls. They've really exerted their will here this afternoon. And it's been in spurts. They kind of offensively got a little stagnant in the third quarter, but the offense for Bill Condon's team certainly picked it up here in the fourth. Big time battle for it, and Conard wins another one of those loose balls on a bounce shot and a nice save by Newman. Good opportunity that time for Jacob Conrad, the junior midfielder. And and Newman up to the task. And Hall back in the other direction. Back behind the net, McHale gets it on the left side to Witter. Spencer Witter, two goals here in the fourth quarter, around the 8 and 9 minute mark respectively. He's the last two times on the score sheet for Hall. And ironically, we're one Conard goal away from having identical scores, girls and boys games here today. Thanks to Sasebo's team dominant and winning 13-4. And Conard one more marker here in the boys game. His pass intercepted at center by the Warriors. Ben Fishman getting an opportunity for Hall. As both teams able to clear the benches here. And Conard will maintain possession after that collision at around the 45-yard line. 2:20 to go. That's all that separates Conard from their 10th victory of the season, as they'll try to better their performance in the Class L tournament from a year ago, ousted in the first round by McMahon. And they'll try to win that first rounder right here. Conard takes a timeout with 2:07 to go, and that'll give us an opportunity to thank our fine sponsors again, this time at the varsity level, including Low Tide Photography, Cork and Bottle, Blue Plate, Fast Eddie, Dave Newman Photography, West Hartford Youth Basketball, West Hartford Boys Travel Basketball, the Open Arm Christian Ministries, Final Cut Barbershop, Edward Connors Insurance, Stanley and Elaine Phillips, Beth Barry Brown of the William Ravis Agency, and the West Hartford Girls Lacrosse Team. Thanks to one and all for your patronage of the War Chief Sports Council so that we can broadcast games like these on WHC-TV Channel 5. And a reminder, we come right back to you on Monday the 23rd. We'll be at the University of Hartford Baseball Stadium. Mayor's Cup action, 2016 edition of Hall versus Conard. 4:30 will be first pitch. Join us live on WHC-TV Channel 5.
And it does look now, coming out of this timeout, that Conard has finally cleared his bench. No noticeable sign of the big five, as it were. O'Connor, Gerundo, McCormick, Nidal. They all appear to have been taken out of this game, given one final send-off, a well-earned sign-off here for the Chieftain seniors, as they have just dominated this game from start to finish. Hall, few opportunities, and again, look at the scoreboard and you don't think about it, but Harrison Newman has played an outstanding game to keep this game as close as it were.
Yeah, he has. He's certainly been one of the MVP performers this afternoon and tonight for this Warriors team. As the clock has stopped with 101 seconds to play, and more changes for this Conard Chieftains team. Hall, as we said, a disappointing conclusion to 2016, but they'll come back, I'm sure, bigger and better next time around. At the 500 mark, at the midway point of the season, they started off 4-4, but they're gonna fall for the 8th consecutive time, and that's the way their season will conclude. Just the opposite of the Chieftains, who battled early injuries and illnesses to start 0-4, but they have certainly reversed their fortunes, having now won with this victory here today 10 out of their last 12. So both Conard programs will be red hot as they go into their respective state tournaments. Until McHale thought about the long shot before he passed it off. This is Kevin Carr with a minute to play in the contest. Long shot taken, and getting a piece of that is the backup netminder. Ramsey Henderson able to deflect that high as that shot from long range from about the 30-yard line. 45 seconds to go. They stay hall possession. Back outside. Long shot again, goes wide. That one taken by Kevin Carr. As you can tell that they're just trying to tee it up and fire from anywhere on the field. Trying to get that elusive fifth goal. Fourth quarter, the only quarter tonight, which Hall has scored multiple goals. They have half their total. Courtesy of Spencer Witter in this fourth quarter. We hope to do a post-game interview with Bill Condon and one of his players. Bill wrapping up his 25th year in regular season fashion. And a long toss into the air by Tyler Granger, and that'll do it. The Conard Chieftains storm onto the field, mobbing the backup goaltender Ramsey Henderson as they complete the victory, winning here today by the score of 12-4, leading from start to finish, a wire-to-wire job, Adam, and very impressive are the Chieftains looking tournament ready.
Complete and total domination on both sides of the ball. Say what you will about momentum. Some people don't believe in it. Some people do. Well, if you do, well, then bet on this Conard team. As I mentioned earlier, now 10 of their last 12 in the win column and ending the season on the highest of high notes, wire-to-wire finish. The first 7 goals in this one. Hall deflated from the get-go, and say what you will, but Von Meyerhauser has a solid core intact for next season. Guys like Chris Mons, Jack McHale, Spencer Witter, they will all be back. That is a solid core to build from. And for Coach Condon, very much on his way to another state playoff berth here, getting to 10 wins, riding again that big five, Jack O'Connor, Jack Arundo, Andrew Hollerback, Matt McCormick, Henry Nadal, all of them finding the net here tonight in just a near flawless game at times, as Conard more physical, faster, more accurate, better in almost every measurable category as they control this game, making it now 5 straight wins over the Hall Warriors.
Well, that'll about do it for our press box coverage. Adam, thank you. It was a pleasure. Nice job in your Channel 5 debut performance here today as the Conard Chieftains win it by the count of 12-4. Stay tuned for our post-game interview with Bill Condon and a player of his choice, and we'll come right back on WHC-TV Channel 5.
मेरे फोटो कट गए ये काट दो
घरी
घरी काय नाही
बनवायचं बाहेर भी खायचं नाही
उद्या ती साडे आठला येणार आहे सकाळी साडे आठला येणार मी खाली जाऊ काय
test.
Coach, congratulations on a nice win.
Thanks.
Fifth consecutive time you've defeated Hall.
You know, everyone is unique. It's fun for the kids. You know, these are kids, you know, they've grown up together, they've played together. It's always a great battle. You know, we have great respect for Hall. So, you know, 5-0 is real nice. We're very happy.
Wire to wire job today. Great job by your kids in the opening quarter to establish yourselves. Got off to the 6-0 lead after one and pretty much had things your own way.
Yeah, this guy next to me had a lot to do with that. The attacker, when our kids are clicking, they really do a great job moving the ball. They share the ball. They're unselfish. It's fun to watch them play. So they did a great job that first quarter.
Defensively, too, overall, assess your performance today.
Again, you know, we're a senior-dominated team at that end of the field. And so our senior goalie and you know, Tyler and Luke and Phil, they do a great job, and Sam. So we're real pleased. And they anchor that end of the field for us.
0-4 to start the season, and then all of a sudden the lights clicked on. 10-2 since then, and you should secure a first-round tournament home game.
That's what we're hoping for. You know, I told the kids before the game, you know, at 0-4, some people really had kind of written us off as far as, geez, Chieftains are down, and a lot of credit to our kids, and, you know, Andrew, one of our four captains, you know, kind of holding it together. And we got it turned around, and then, you know, that's what we got to.
Congratulations on a great game and a great season and all the success in the playoffs.
Great. Thank you very much. And thank you for being here tonight.
Our pleasure. Andrew, great job. Great start today by your team. You guys, you and we call them the Big Five, the five of you that have double-digit goals on the season and really came through big time.
Yeah, I don't know. We're just a really unselfish team. We've been playing with each other for a really long time, so we kind of all know where we're going to be. And I don't know, it just a lot of fun, a lot of fun.
10-6 a year ago, you lost in the opening round of the state tournament to McMahon. 10-6 identical record this time around. What could be different about this team that could make a run in the 2016 CIAC Class L playoffs?
Kind of the same personnel, but we got another year of experience together, and we're just ready to play. Last year we were ready to play too, but this year we're all seniors, got to have a good way to go out, you know?
You learned something from that first round exit last year?
Yes, for sure. That was a bummer, but we're looking to make a run here, so we're excited.
0-4 to start the season, and all of a sudden you guys flip the switch individually and collectively, and here you are 12 games later, 10-2 in your last 12. And what was wrong early, and what has gone better lately?
The first couple of games, we didn't really play together as a team. We were being a little bit selfish, and I don't know, things were just not like our usual unselfish team. But once we got it going, we got a few wins under our belt against a couple of good teams like East Catholic, South Windsor. We just kept rolling and feeling that energy and just kept going. And that's really what got us to where we are now, 10-2 after that 0-4 start.
Congratulations on the win today. Go get them in that state tournament.
Hey, thanks a lot.
Okay. Andrew Hollerback joining us. With the win today, the Conard Chieftains, 10-6 as they go into the Class L playoffs, should get a first-round home game. And they completed the sweep today for the Conard Chieftains as the girls won the opener 13-4. The guys doing the nightcap by the count of 12-4. Thanks to all involved. And a reminder, join us again on May 23rd, the Mayor's Cup baseball game, 4:30 from the University of Hartford. If you can't see it on TV, join us at the game live or online at whc-tv.org. Until next time, Pete Lamoureux saying thanks for watching. And good night from Robert J. McKee Stadium in West Hartford.